Hey guys, in this video I want to go over this calculus 3 problem. It says find a unit normal vector at the given point, and then we're given a vector function r of t in three-dimensional space and a point in three-dimensional space, which is 1, 0, 0. So let's go ahead and get started with solving this problem. The unit normal vector n of t is equal to t prime over the magnitude of t prime, where t is equal to the tangent vector, and the tangent vector t has its own formula, which is r prime over the magnitude of r prime, and r refers to the vector function which we're given. So first we have to solve for t, and then we're going to plug in t prime and the magnitude of t prime to get our final solution. So r prime of t is equal to the derivatives of the three components of r of t. So the derivative of cosine t is equal to negative sine t. The derivative of sine t is cosine t. And the derivative of the natural log of cosine t is equal to negative sine t over cosine t. This is also equal to negative tangent t. Then we have to find the magnitude of r prime. So the magnitude of r prime t is equal to the square root of the sum of the squares of each of the three components. So that's going to be equal to sine squared t plus cosine squared t plus tangent squared t. Sine squared t plus cosine squared t is equal to 1, so we can simplify this as being equal to 1 plus tangent squared t. And that can be simplified as well as being equal to secant squared t. And the square root of secant squared t is equal to secant of t, or that's also the same as saying 1 over cosine t. So now that we have r prime and the magnitude of r prime, we can plug in both those equations to solve for t. So t is going to be equal to, for the first component, it's going to be negative sine t over secant t, which is equal to 1 over cosine t, so that's equal to times cosine t. For the second component, it's going to be cosine squared t. And for the third component, the cosines are going to cancel out, so you're going to have negative sine t. Now that I know the three components for t, I'm going to solve for n of t. So I have to find t prime and the magnitude of t prime. So again, for finding t prime, I'm just going to take the derivative of each of the three components of t. So negative sine t times cosine t, I'm going to use the product rule. So that's going to be equal to negative sine t times negative sine t plus negative cosine t times cosine t for the first component. For the second component, I'm going to get negative 2 cosine t times sine t. And for the third component, I'm going to get negative cosine t. Instead of solving for the magnitude of t prime, since that's going to be a long calculation, I'm now going to use the other information that I'm given in the problem, which is that we're solving for the unit vector at the point 1, 0, 0. So I'm going to now use this information for finding the magnitude of t prime. So we're given in the problem the point 1, 0, 0, and then if we think of r of t as the position function in three dimensions, then we want to find the time t where r of t is going to give me the position 1, 0, 0. So we see for example, the first component, I want position 1, so the time t that would give me position 1 in r of t is going to be t is equal to 0. And if we check for the three components, we're going to see that time of t equal to 0 gives us this point in space. So cosine of 0 is equal to 1, sine of 0 is equal to 0, and the natural log of cosine of 0 is also equal to 0. So this point is going to be in this r of t when t is equal to 0. So instead of finding the magnitude of t prime for any value t, I'm first going to find t prime at time t is equal to 0, so t prime of 0. So that's going to be equal to, if we plug in 0 for the t's here, that's going to be 0 minus 1 for the first component. For the second component, we're going to get 0, and for the third component, we're going to get negative 1. So at time t is equal to 0, t prime is equal to negative 1, 0, negative 1. And now it's a lot easier for us to find the magnitude of t prime because we know we're finding it for time t is equal to 0. So that's going to be equal to the square root of the sums of the squares of the components. So that's going to be the square root of negative 1 squared plus 0 squared plus the square of negative 1. So that's just going to be equal to the square root of 2. So now we can plug into our final answer. So n of t at the time t is equal to 0 is going to be equal to negative 1, 0, negative 1 divided by the square root of 2. Or the final answer is the negative 1 divided by the square root of 2, 0, negative 1 divided by the square root of 2. And this is our final answer, and we're done with this problem.